When I was 7 or 8 years old, The Lion King was playing in the Circus Theater in the Netherlands, in Scheveningen, the beach area. And I remember very distinctly my parents and my sister, we were going to the beach, and you park your car and then you come out and then you basically look at the Circus Theater. So I remember walking there and it was just a huge, huge yellow poster. And I remember being super confused, but my absolute obsession with Disney musicals was already very much alive. So I was like, why is Mufasa on this poster? The Lion King? Are they screening The Lion King here? And I remember this moment so much because I was super curious and I looked up everything afterwards on Wikipedia, like the giant nerd I was slash am. And I never got to see it that summer. When they announced the musical was coming back to the Netherlands, I remember thinking very distinctly, I have a feeling I should not go. And I have a friend, Jamie, who went in London, and I asked her, Jamie, do you think I should go to the Dutch one, or is the West End version so much better that I should go there? And she said, oh no, definitely don't go to the Dutch one. If you can, go to the London version. So I thought, okay, I'm not gonna go see this one. The plan was to go to London just for a trip to go and see some stuff. Never really turned out the way I wanted to, and a lot of people and scheduling and stuff. And here I am today in New York City, and I am finally going to give that 8-year-old girl the gift that she couldn't give herself back then. I am going to see The Lion King on Broadway today. It is my final musical here, and I am fucking hyped. I am so happy. It was so expensive, and it doesn't matter. I will work my butt off again to recuperate all of the money I am putting into this, but I am so hyped because I know I love this. I already know that I love this piece of musical theater, and I am finally going to see it live in its ultimate form. That was my prologue. Now let's go. Let's go, ladies and gentlemen. I wonder where I have to go. Oh my goodness. Ta-da!
The king of beasts with quite so little hair.
I'm gonna be the main event, like no king was before. I'm busting up on looking down, I'm working on my roar.
Thus far, a rather uninspiring thing.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king. And almost a
be great. Carlo, wat vond je van The Lion King?
Ik vind het geniaal. Nou, verschrikkelijk leuk. Zo creatief. Het vakmanschap klapt er vanaf, want laten we wel aan decors en aan kleding. Jezus, wat mensen, dat zeg ik echt maar zinnig. Dus je valt echt van de ene verbazing in de andere. Het is zo fantasierijk. En daar heb je mij gelijk mee te pakken. Want echt iedere seconde denk ik, oh, wat gaat er nu weer gebeuren? Oh, wat gaat er nu weer gebeuren?
En hij heeft het al twee keer gezien.
Het is voor mij de derde keer dat ik het gezien heb. En ik ben er weer helemaal door gegrepen. Echt, het is heel indrukwekkend. Het ontroert me gewoon. Ik zit naar een stel zebras te kijken en ik ben met tranen in mijn ogen, weet je wel. Ja, dat is toch wel gewoon knap. Dat is echt, ja, echt fantastisch.
The last time I walked home from a Broadway show. I am, I don't feel great, to be honest. This was the best ending of three great months I could have. I am so happy I had the chance to see this year. I am moved. This one's absolutely spectacular. I am so happy. Like Carlo says, feel like a child again. I think that eight-year-old is very happy that she waited a little to see The Lion King in all its splendor. I am, this was one of the best things I've seen here. It's funny because A Strange Loop is up there making fun of this show, but I love it with all my heart. I think this show is the pinnacle of pure artistry, where everything you can see and everything you can hear is just a masterful level of art. It's just art. Just look at the fabrics all of these characters wear, all of the puppets who not only on a technical level work perfectly, but are like an extension of a personality as well. Where dance is used in such a moving way, where the story is always clear to me. I have never in my life seen so many ensemble members in my life. At some point, there were at least 25 hyenas on stage, which is ridiculous. It was fantastic. All of the main actors were absolutely terrific, except the kids. I already told Carlo that I was going to be critical of the kids, and I am critical of the kids, and my Simba was just not vocally amazing. All the other stuff was great, but he just didn't hit the notes very comfortably or something. It felt really forced. The only other negative thing I'll say about the show is that I think that some places felt very rushed. There were two moments that I thought, whoa, Jesus, take it easy. And I understand that it's probably because it's a kid's show and you gotta keep things moving, but still, Mufasa's death and the reunion of Simba and Nala was so fast. That's too bad because it takes away from the gravity of both situations, but hey, I understand it as a choice. The best thing about the show was Rafiki. No doubt about it. What a powerhouse. So funny. So great. I wish you could have heard this woman's voice. Just absolute perfection. You already know these songs. You basically have the show memorized. Very dangerous because you can compare. And this was even better. What a phenomenal woman. I am so happy. Our Mufasa had a beautiful voice. Our Simba was great in this role. Nala as well. Oh my god, Shadowlands, fantastic. And even the bits with the hyenas, which, you know, as a 22-year-old woman are a little less funny than when I was a kid, I still respect them very much. I also told Carlo that the show is very well balanced. It has very beautiful, touching moments, and it's funny and quick enough to enjoy for children. They also said when the show opened something about like children going there and maybe having their very first theater experience, and I was like, oh my god, that's beautiful. I remember so well the first time I saw something big in a theater. I was just crying because I was so overwhelmed by the beauty of everything. It was Mary Poppins, by the way, my first big real theater experience, and I started crying like a little bitch. I cried so much. I cried at the beginning. I cried basically every time Rafiki was there. I was so, oh god. And of course, part of it is going to be nostalgia, but part of it is also just they did so much justice to the movie, and there were parts that made the story so much richer and more clear and more well-rounded. Oh my god, the stampede! What the fuck? That was one of the coolest things I've ever seen in my life. I was in awe of everything. Oh my god, and also Mufasa's mask when he's talking to his son. Oh my god, just really, 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 really spectacular things. And I'm leaving this place with a great last experience, and I feel wonderful, and I feel sad because I have to go, but I know I will be back. I know I will be back. I'm sure of this. So yeah, that was the last ORI on Broadway of the summer of 2019, everybody. It went as soon as it came, and we are now finished. I bid you all farewell. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see a bunch of you as soon as I get back. Wish me a good flight, because I need it. Goodbye, everybody, and goodbye to Broadway for now.